rough.
I find it hilarious when people think that new game Steep has some funny, silly features like, haha, you can put a giraffe on your head while I'm Mr. Skeleton riding a coffin down the mountain, so don't talk to me about silly. Welcome to SSX 3, the greatest video game ever made about anything. Ever. Cause I know most people hate EA nowadays, but just over 13 years ago, EA big, and I love the sound effect as much as you do.
EA Sports.
Created this masterpiece of a game, and no snowboarding game, in my opinion, even comes close. Not even the other games in the SSX series, including the most recent iteration, which unequivocally is a ball of hot garbage. I admit the original SSX Tricky was fantastic, but it's just not the legendary SSX 3. And in case you're wondering where the word Tricky came from, it comes from exactly where you think it comes from. As you start your journey to conquer the mountain, you have to select a character, and ignoring the cheat characters, which I will get into later, you have 10 to choose from. Zoe, who has daddy issues, Moby I've admittedly never played, Griff is the personification of like a bowl of Lucky Charms, Vigo is 20 pounds of cool in a 5-pound bucket, Elise is admitting to yourself I have zero imagination and I hate making decisions. Nate's a motard. Allegra shares the same name as that allergy medicine, which is pretty weird if you ask me. And Kaori is so stereotypically Japanese that I'm surprised she doesn't burst into chunks of sushi when she falls over. The only two acceptable characters to play are either Mac or Simon, but I've always just picked Simon, and I think the easiest way to describe him is that there's no coincidence that the words psychotic and Simon both start with the same three letters. Once you've selected your character, you can proceed to start conquering the mountain, one peak at a time. There's three peaks in total, and within each peak, you have three different modes: race, freestyle, and freeride. Race is basically punching everyone in the face and making sure you cross the finish line first. Freestyle is scored based on the number of tricks you can bust out, which means spinning around in circles until your eyes bleed, and free ride is doing tedious challenges and collecting snowflakes. Yeah, no, but nobody likes free ride. Not even me. And once you've completed enough races, events, and challenges, you get to face off against your rival for that particular peak, which is basically just a competitor that happens to be talking the most amount of shit.
Hey, Simon! I'm giving you one chance to race me in the backcountry. Take it or leave it.
But thankfully, you can use your hard-earned cash to upgrade your character's appearance, stats, and even the tricks they can perform. And personally, I love the customization of your character because you start out with a fairly normal-looking human being and you can turn them into anything you want. Like literally a boxing glove with boxing glove hands, wearing cinder blocks for boots, riding a cardboard box with a bear trap stuck to your thighs. But don't think it stops there. You can throw on a pumpkin head, a human skull, a balloon, even a straitjacket and firecrackers. That's one of my favorites, by the way. There's nothing quite like punching someone in the face with a lit firecracker. And much like the cardboard box, if riding down the mountain on a snowboard isn't your thing, you can always just select the skateboard deck, or a surfboard, or a futuristic hoverboard. It doesn't really matter. This right here is my favorite setup with the flaming pumpkin head, but many different characters have a ton of different secret unlockables, so I'll leave that for you to explore. Some of the stuff just outright doesn't make sense, like you can punch other riders in the face while you're in a straitjacket. I don't know how that one works. And you can also light your cardboard box on fire and ride it down the mountain. I don't know how it doesn't, like, disintegrate before you get to the bottom, but I don't know. Physics.
JB's weekly mountain bike night ride one. It seems Mac feels bragging.
And once you're set up with your character, you can finally learn what makes this game so special, and that's this nifty little feature called the Uber. Yeah, it's kind of weird when people say Uber so often nowadays, because the first thing that pops into my brain isn't a ride-sharing service, it's more like a psychotic, pumpkin-wearing madman flipping around like a dolphin 100 feet in the air. So how it works is, as you're cruising down the mountain, you can perform a variety of different tricks. These can be grabs, front flips, back flips, twists, tweaks, you name it, and when you complete these tricks, you start to fill up this nifty little Uber bar on the ride. The more advanced the tricks are, the more points you get, the more you fill up the bar. Pretty simple. Now you can use this bar as fuel to speed yourself up, or you can fill it up all the way and unlock your Uber ability. And your Uber ability allows you to perform specialized tricks that result in much higher points and all around look pretty damn gnarly. And every time you perform one of these tricks, you receive a letter towards unlocking Uber Zone 2 by spelling the word Uber. This applies to grinding as well, so you're welcome to sit on your board or stand your board on its end or even perform a handstand. stand while you're flailing your legs around, it all contributes to an Uber. Now, Uber Zone 2 allows you to perform more specialized Uber tricks that are even fancier than your regular Uber tricks, such as my two personal favorites of the banger, which looks like you're firing your board as a shotgun, and the guillotine, where Simon spins the board around his neck at a rate that looks like he's gonna slice his head off. Just keep in mind that if you fall or have to reset while in Uber Zone 1 or 2, you automatically lose your Uber and you have to start with the regular tricks all over again. But once you perform enough of these Uber tricks and spell the word Super Uber, you unlock Uber Zone 3, which basically makes you into a superhero. Using your speed boost no longer drains your Uber bar, which means that you can go crazy fast, and you falling doesn't result in the loss of your Uber, which makes you kind of just like invincible while it's active. Now this does eventually run out, but you can always just perform 5 more Uber tricks to spell the word super again, and you'll get it right back. You can actually purchase new Uber tricks and select the 4 ones that you like best, which is excellent. You can even preview what the trick looks like before you buy it. And I gotta say, this feature of the game is what makes it truly unique and memorable, because it permeates all aspects of the game, and it's brilliant. And you can think about that this way. Because of the speed boost that it can offer, it incentivizes you to perform incredible stunts even while not in a trick-based game mode like Race, so you can constantly have a speed boost and just crush everybody. So the guy that wins isn't necessarily just the guy that blazes down the hill as fast as he can, it's the guy that blazes down the hill as fast as he can in style. Now I should mention there's another way to get an Uber. Yeah, you don't have to perform those low-level tricks all the time. If you can simply knock down a competitor, you get it immediately. I'm not gonna say it's the easiest thing in the world to do, but that's my routine every single race. You just bust out of the gate, sock somebody in the face, and just take off down the hill with your Uber boost. It's even better if you charge it up for a while, because it hits like a truck. And when it comes to freestyle events, which, let's be honest, they're the most fun events that there are, you've got slopestyle, big air, and superpipe, which are all pretty much just like holding Ubers for as long as you can, but spinning around like a top is pretty fun after a while. And for the record, peak one is by far the very best peak. Just because it's sunny, the maps have some sort of variety to them, and there's not just a stupid amount of randomness. Yeah, peak three is clearly the worst, because it's just random shit smacking into you all the time, and the weather is terrible. So peak one or peak two all the way.
Oh, great, my life just passed before my eyes!
And eventually, you'll have more cash than you know what to do with, which is when you can start unlocking and buying cheat characters. Let's see, we got Canuck, who's a beaver riding a sharp log, the Unknown Rider, who looks like a Mortal Kombat character, the Northwest Legend, who's just a giant Yeti. Yeah, he's pretty fun in racing events. Gutless is the coffin-riding skeleton that we talked about earlier, Churchill, which is some kind of like robotic industrial machine, and Snowball, who I can only assume is Frosty the Snowman. A lot of you are already pissed off that I didn't just backdrop the entire video with Cudmore the cow, and yes, you can literally play as a cow, which, I don't know, that's just EA back in 2003. There are definitely some ones that I missed, but those are the only ones that I've played with in the past, and I do find it pretty funny that there are more secret characters than regular characters in the game, even though they're all really just skins. And oh my god, I cannot forget DJ Atomica and the legendary radio of EA Big. You don't understand how good this radio station is.
We're back with EA Radio Big. Here's a breaking story. Seems that it's that time of year again. Reports are coming in fast and furious that, yes, the dreaded snow snakes are back. Now here's some mountain history. Community elections are held every 2 years, and a mayor is chosen by Big Mountain citizens. Over the years, participants have included a dishwasher, a dead guy, a convicted serial killer, and last year's almost winner, an avalanche dog named Tiger. Yep, just another slice of life in the mountains.
It's actually a little frightening how much Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 2 and SSX 3 shaped my musical tastes growing up. And although I can't play the songs for you right now, I will definitely leave a link in the description to see where you can go find them, because they're so perfect. And that's about it. I'd like to thank you very much for joining me in the best game ever to grace God's green earth, and I'll see you next time when we complain about how YouTube is broken.